Jayaprakash Gandhi, Craig Consultant and Analyst. Lot of students wanted to know, sir, how NEET 2021 will be? What are the chapters we need to give weightage? How the exams are going to be conducted? In fact, NEET 2021, now as per the latest information, it might be conducted twice because the Ministry of Health has given permission to National Testing Agency to conduct NEET 2021 twice. So we are expecting the notification very soon, and maybe exams might be in May, June also. So the best of the scores will be taken. Again, here the many students want to know, sir, whether it will be score a percentile, how that they do it percentile in NEET, in JEE Main, how they are going to take it up. So we have to wait and see the official notification. In fact, we would be very happy if they take the best of the marks rather than the percentile system, because in admissions to medical counseling, it will be better if they have marks so that ranking can be much easier. So anyway, we have to wait and see how the National Testing Agency is going to really spell out their regulations and the process for the NEET 2021 and subsequently the medical admissions for the year 2021. In fact, but make sure, my dear students, because it's going to be two times, it's better that you need to really prepare, start preparing well. You should know which chapters to be given weightage, which chapters will have a lot of advantage in case you're really strong in your concept knowledge. So all this you need to really know about it. The first we'll see about the subject wise. NEET 2021, we expect the following in physics. In class 11, I repeat, in class 11 in physics, the physical world units and measurements will have 2% of weightage. Motion in a straight line, motion in a plane will have 3%. Loss of motion will be 3%. Work, energy and power will be 4%. System of particles and rotational motion will be 5%. Gravitation will be 2%. Mechanical properties of solids, mechanical properties of fluids, thermal properties of matter will be 3%. And thermodynamics will be 9%. Kinetic theory will be 3%. Oscillation waves will be 3%. So in fact, you need to really give weightage in physics class 11, thermodynamics, that should be the very important. System of particles and rotation motion also should give lot of importance. And also work, energy and power. These are the chapters you need to be very strong in class 11. In class 12, electric charges and fields, electrostatic potentials and capacitance will be 9% weightage. Current electricity will be 8%. Moving charges and magnetism and matter will have 5%. Electromagnetic induction and alternating current will be 8%. Electromagnetic waves will be 5%. Ray optics and optical instruments and ray optics in class 12 will be 10% weightage. Dual nature of radiation and matter will be 6%. Atoms and nuclear will be 3%. Semiconductor and electronics will be 9%. So overall, if you see in class 12, you should be really strong in semiconductor electronics, ray optics and optical instruments and ray optics, which will have 10% of the questions. Then electromagnetic induction and alternating current will be 8%. Current electricity will be 8%. And electric charges and fields, electrostatic potential and capacitance will be 9%. So if you overall look, it's better that the weightage in 12th standard, you should be really strong. In fact, if you want to really have a good score in physics. Because Robert, in NEET, out of 180 marks, you need to score at least 100 plus marks to stay that the magic number of 600 plus in NEET out of 720. Right, in chemistry, we in class 11, you should give the following will be the weightage. Basic concepts of chemistry will be 1%. Structure of atom will be 2%. Classification of elements and periodicity in properties will be 2%. Chemical bonding and molecular structure will be 5%. State of matters, gases and liquids will be 2%. thermodynamics will be 8%, equilibrium will be 6%, redox reactions will be 3%, then S block elements will be 2%, P block elements will be 2%, organic chemistry basic principle and techniques will be 4%, hydrocarbons will be 3%, environmental chemistry will be 2%. So if you look at the chemistry weightage, you should be really very strong in organic chemistry, basic principle and techniques, hydrocarbons, and also you should be very strong in equilibrium, thermodynamics, chemical bonding, molecular structure. These are the major chapters you need to really have weightage in class 11 in chemistry. Class 12 in chemistry, solid state will have 2% of weightage, solutions will be have 2%, electrochemistry will be 2%, chemical kinetics will be 3%, surface chemistry will be 2%, isolation of elements will be 2%, P block elements will be 5%, D block and F block will be 4%, coordination compound will be 9%, halogen and halogens will be 9%, alcohol, phenols and ethers will be 4%, ketones and carbolic acid will be 4%, organic compounds containing nitrogen will be 2%, biomolecules will be 3%, polymers will be 3%, and chemistry in everyday life will be 2%. So you should be very strong in class 12 in NEET will be coordination compound, which has almost 9%, and also in alcohol, phenols and ethers will be about 4%, carbolic acid, ketones also will have 4%. So you should be very strong in your D block and F block and also P block elements, and also if possible chemical kinetics. These are the chapters you should be very strong in NEET chemistry in class 12. So if you look at class 11, class 12 have equal distribution. So you should really prepare well from class 11 and class 12 and make sure that you need to really score almost 150 marks out of 180 if you want to touch the magic number of 600 out of 720. And in biology, which is very, very important, because you know that out of 360 marks, you need to really score about 350 marks. So biology should be very, very strong, both botany and zoology. If you look at the weightage in biology, which combines both botany and zoology, the living world, biological classification, planet kingdom, animal kingdom will have 14%. Morphology of flowering plants, anatomy of flowering plants, structural organization animals will have 5%. The cell, the unit of life, biomolecules, cell cycle and cell division will have 9% questions weightage. Then in class 11 also, photosynthesis in higher plants, transport in plants, mineral nutrition, plant growth and development, respiration in plants will have 6% weightage. Then digestion and absorption, breathing and exchange of gases, body fluid circulations, excretory products and their elimination, locomotion and movement, neural control and coordination, chemical coordination and integration will have 20%. So in chapter 11, in class 11 in biology, you should be very strong in digestion and absorption, breathing and exchange of gases, body fluids and circulations, locomotion and movement, chemical coordination and integration, you should be very strong. Same way in class 11, you should be very strong in your living world, biological classifications, planet kingdom and animal kingdom. And also you should be very strong in your 11th of cell, the unit of life, biomolecules, cell cycle and cell division. These are the class 11 biology weighted. In class 12 biology, you should be very strong in really in principle of inheritance of variations, molecular basis of inheritance and evaluation, which will concern about 18%. Reproduction in organization, sexual reproduction in flowering plants, human reproduction and reproductive health will have 9%. Human health and diseases, strategies in enhancement in food productions, microbes in human welfare will have 9%. And biotechnology principle process, biotechnology and application will have 4% weightage. Organizations and populations, ecosystems, biodiversity and conservation, environmental issues will have 6%. So you should be in class 12, you should be really strong in the first chapter to 10th chapter, that is reproduction organizations, sexual reproduction in flowering plants, human reproduction, reproductive health, principle of inheritance and variations, molecular basis of inheritance, evaluation, human health and diseases, strategies and enhancement in food productions, microbes and human welfare. These are the real, the first 10 chapters in class 12 in biology, both botany and zoology. You should be really strong. And make sure, I told you, prepare from your NCERT books, because that is going to give you really edge over the other materials also. Because if you are very strong in your basic concepts and prepare from NCERT, definitely you can score that 350 out of 360 in biology. So overall you can touch 600. And make sure, my simple advice to you, please, when the NEET call for comes, please apply for both the exams. Don't write only one, write both the exams. Best of the scores will be taken, because it's going to be highly competitive, because when two times conducted, there's every possibility that many students will get the higher possibility rank and the scores. So make sure you apply for both, prepare well, because again and again, it's a wonderful career to be a medical professional, especially to be an MBBS. After that, you do your post-graduation, be a medical practitioner. That's a great, great growth in your career. And it's a dream career for many of you. So really prepare well. The Career Guidance JP Gandhi YouTube channel will support you, will guide you in every step you take forward related to NEET 2021 preparation. Thank you so much.